Namaste children, I am Smita, your English teacher from Mangala Vidya Mandira. Class 8 standard, subject English. In the previous class, you all learnt about Sir C.V. Raman's childhood, his education, the exams he passed and also his strong liking for science, isn't it? So, let us continue the lesson. So, Unit 2 Prose, Sir C.V. Raman. In 1911, Raman was appointed Special Accountant General for Posts and Telegraphs in Calcutta. But when he was offered the post of Professor at Calcutta University, he jumped at that offer and accepted the post gladly. After working at Calcutta University for 15 years, he became the Director of the Indian Institute of Science in Bengaluru. The Raman Research Institute was started in 1948. Raman resigned his post at the Indian Institute of Science and became the director of the research institute. Here he conducted his research in physics until his death. Now, Sir C.V. Raman in the year 1911 was appointed as Special Accountant General for Posts and Telegraphs in Calcutta. But at that time, he got a post of professor at Calcutta University and he was very happy to take that offer. He worked there for 15 years and later became director of Indian Institute of Science in Bengaluru. Raman Research Institute was started in 1948, so he resigned his post in Indian Institute of Science and became the director of Research Institute. So this is where he started and continued his research in physics until his death. Sir C.V. Raman was a great scientist. Throughout his life, he was intensely attached to science. For the sake of science, he gave up the highly paid post of the Special Accountant General and accepted a professorship at Calcutta University. He would forget all about food and rest while he was at work, and his wife had often to tell him that his breakfast or coffee was getting cold. Like all great scientists, Raman had a lot of curiosity. Earlier in his life, while on a voyage to Europe, he saw the wonderful blue of the Mediterranean Sea. This led to his work on the laws of light scattering in liquids and it ended in his discovery of the Raman effect. He was awarded the Nobel Prize for this in 1930. So, Sir C.V. Raman, children, was so much interested in science that he gave up his high-paid Special Accountant General job and he became professor at Calcutta University. He would forget about food and rest while working. Such was the curiosity of Sir C.V. Raman or his passion towards work. So once while he was travelling to Europe, he saw the beautiful blue colour of Mediterranean Sea. This made him to work on the laws of light scattering in liquids, which resulted in his famous work. So what is it called as? Raman effect. He was awarded Nobel Prize in 1930 for the same. Raman was a kind man. He helped people when they were in difficulty. When he was working as Deputy Accountant General, a villager went to him with some badly burnt 100-rupee notes. Any other person perhaps would have turned the villager away, but Raman took pity on the villager, examined the notes himself, and allowed the villager to exchange the burnt notes for new ones. Okay, so children, being a great scientist is a great thing, isn't it? But Sir C.V. Raman was also a kind man. While he was working as a Deputy Accountant General, a villager, he came to Sir C.V. Raman with burnt 100-rupee notes. Maybe he was a poor man. So any other person would have sent him away with the notes. But Sir C.V. Raman was very generous. So what did he do? He exchanged the man's notes for the new notes. Okay, so once at the Raman Research Institute, a candidate was not given admission as he did not do well in his tests. When his traveling allowance was paid, the candidate found that he had received more. He returned to the office to pay back the excess amount. When Raman came to know of this, he liked the candidate's honesty and admitted him to the institute. The candidate was not able to make out why he was admitted when he had not done well in his test. It seems Raman told the candidate, "I have admitted you to the institute because of your character. You are not very good at physics, but I can teach you." See, children, in another instance, what happened, a candidate came to take test in a research institute. but he failed because he did not get good marks. So his traveling allowance was given, and the candidate realized that he was paid more money as allowance. Okay, so what did he do? He returned the extra amount that he received to the office. And when Sir C.V. Raman came to know what this candidate did, he was very happy and he gave him admission in his institute. Now the candidate did not understand why he was admitted. So Sir C.V. Raman told him that he was given admission due to his good character. And he also continued saying that though he was not very good in physics, he could teach physics to the candidate. Children, this shows that Sir C.V. Raman was, he not only gave importance to one's knowledge, but also to one's character. So acquiring knowledge or information is not all. You should also be humble in your behavior, isn't it? So such was the nature of Sir C.V. Raman. During his lifetime, Raman received a number of honors and medals. In 1929, he was knighted by King George V and became Sir C.V. Raman. A number of universities honored him with doctorates. He was a member of many international scientific organizations. In 1954, the government of India awarded him Bharat Ratna. In 1957, the Soviet Union honored him by awarding the International Lenin Prize. Raman died on November 21, 1970 at the age of 82. In his death, India lost one of her great sons and the world a great scientist. So Sir C.V. Raman, he received a number of medals. Children, knighthood is the official title which is given to people who have done some extraordinary service or outstanding achievement. Then they will be addressed as Sir. So Sir C.V. Raman. Okay, Sir C.V. Raman was knighted by King George V and he became Sir C.V. Raman. So he got many doctorate awards and he became a member of international scientific organizations also. So in 1954, Sir C.V. Raman also received prestigious Bharat Ratna Award. And in 1957, Soviet Union awarded him with International Lenin Prize. Now, however, Sir C.V. Raman died in the year 1970 on November 21st at the age of 82. So India lost one of the greatest scientists ever. So I hope you have understood the lesson, children. Children, we should be proud that such a great scientist was born in India and made India proud for his achievements. And one more thing, no matter how great or famous you are, you should never forget your base. Sir C.V. Raman was both great and humble, and he was respected highly for that. So, children, if you have passion and determination to learn, you can reach any heights. I hope the lesson is clear to you. Now, let us go to the homework part. Now, who is your favorite scientist and why? Write about it in 8 to 10 sentences. So, you should write about your favorite scientist and also the reason. Okay, so write about it in 8 to 10 sentences and send it through WhatsApp. Okay, thank you, children. And the next part, the grammar related to the lesson will be done. Thank you, children.